video. Today, I am going to play Bloons Tower Defense 6 ASMR formatted. So, essentially, it's a tower defense game, which I will have to prevent balloons from reaching from the start to the end of the path, and I have to build towers to destroy the balloons or pop them, better off say that. Okay, so this guy is a monkey and I made him put it there that this monkey will attack the balloons. Okay, so this game is very easy, but it can be very challenging if you play on the harder maps. So I actually made other videos, ASMR videos on this game, but it's been a while since I played this game in this video, in a video, okay? And now we are now playing through the rounds of this game, okay? Okay, so we are now in round 4, and as you can see, the balloons are getting tougher and tougher to beat. So we are facing blue balloons, which are different than reds, and that's the new enemy. So what's different is that if you pop a blue balloon, it has a red balloon inside of it, okay? And this is the main function, that is the main gimmick of this game, or I should say the main idea of this game. Basically popping balloons that contain children or other balloons inside of it, or something like that. So a blue becomes a red and a red becomes nothing. So like the red is like the lowest, the base. It's just if you pop a red, that's it. But if you pop a blue, it has red inside. So I'm gonna make this, since I made other videos before in this game, like I made a video on this game, I'm gonna do something different, in which I'm gonna place down a different hero, okay? So,
order up, height.
This is another special hero order that I have not used in any of my videos on Bloons Tower Defense 6, okay? Okay. And if you don't know, if you have not watched my other videos on this game, heroes are basically special characters that you can place alongside the other towers that you defend with. So in fact, I'm gonna place down another tower that is different, okay? Well, I was going to say something other than that, but in fact, this hero does not attack. This hero is usually attack enemies or balloons, but this one does not really directly attack balloons, but rather weakens them, and you create money. It creates money. It's basically a computer-themed hero, and basically uses hacks, quote-unquote, to weaken the balloons and create money, make money directly. Okay, so I'm gonna place another tower that I've never used I think it's a blue boomerang monkey. Basically throws boomerangs, that's it. Okay. And I see green balloons, which move faster, but contain blues. If Bob, so a green pops into a blue. If you pop a green, it becomes a blue. If you pop a blue, it becomes a red. Okay. So, yeah. Also, I can upgrade towers. There are many different ways to upgrade a specific tower. Like this one turns. I bought an upgrade before, and it basically pops more balloons. But if I create, if I upgrade this to glaives, it's gonna turn all my boomerangs to glaives. And also, there's other paths of upgrades that I could use. Like a tower has three different ways or paths to upgrade. So, I'm going to upgrade this. I could use two paths, up to two paths. Upgrade to on two paths or something, yeah. So, in other words, basically I could upgrade the tower from one path, and also I could also upgrade on another path alongside the top, the first path, so up to two paths. Okay. There are so many ways. There are so many unique kinds of upgrades towers have, and they don't just give extra range or extra speed or something like that. They can do other special things, especially on the advanced upgrades. In this game, it's called tiers. Okay. So more of the green balloons. We are now in round 12 of this game, and now I see yellow balloons. They move much faster, and if I pop a yellow, it turns into a green. Okay. I'm gonna also place another tower that I've never used. I think I've never used in any of my other videos. It is a glue gunner. Basically slows them down. See, basically soaks balloons into glue. Okay. Alright, so there are upgrades to this guy. Like all of the other towers, they are three paths. So I'm gonna upgrade this guy to a glue soak, which basically coats all of the children inside. And I could also make it pop every few seconds. So basically corrosive glue that pops. Alright. This game is super cool, and there's so much replayability, that's how I find it. And if I choose to play this, there's so many ways you can play, and so many towers, and so many strategies you can use. There are 20 towers, more than 20 towers, I think. Five, yeah. Towers in this game, and each have 15 total upgrades, different upgrades. So yeah, so I'm gonna upgrade this guy further, and this is where the game gets really weird. Balloons, you see those heart-shaped balloons? These are regen balloons or regrow balloons. And that's the first weird part of this game. Basically, if you pop a heart-shaped regrow balloon, it will regrow its lair if you don't pop it quickly. is really taking care of all of the balloons. It pops because I set it to corrosive.
Okay.
So you see there are more of these yellow heart-shaped balloons. They regrow into their original size or layer. Okay, so here are black balloons, okay? So blacks are really what makes balloons become unrealistic. So the last round had black balloons. Basically, they are immune to bombs. So I placed another bomb shooter. On medium, which is basically not kind of not really like easy mode, but kind of like a bit harder than easy. Okay. More leads, lead balloons. Okay. If I pop those, they contain two black balloons. And it's kind of annoying that you need bombs or explosives to pop lead, but inside are black balloons which are immune to bombs or explosives, so you kind of have to have a blend of towers that can pop lead and towers that can pop black. Okay. Oh yeah, you see these white and black zebra balloons? They are immune to freezing and bombs or explosives. Look at that. They are not affected. These blacks. Boom. 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 Even bigger bombs. Normally, I would not place towers like this, but I'm just placing towers to kind of show you all some of the towers. Oh yeah, these are purples. Purple balloons. If you've seen them, the purple balloons that you just saw are immune to anything magical, like wizards can't pop purples for the most part. Okay, so here are more camo balloons. Like, you see those patterns, the balloons with this camo pattern. This is a camo. You can't really pop camo if you can't see. Like towers, most towers can't see about camo on their own. They need to be upgraded to a certain. There's like most towers have certain upgrades that can pop these camo balloons. Okay. Basically, a camouflaged version of a balloon. Okay. So these zebras here, you can see that they're also immune to bombs and freezing. So they have the properties of black balloons and white balloons combined.
Basically, it throws at a much faster pace, much
accelerated speed, like it temporarily increases your speed, the speed of the tower. Okay, so I'm gonna use it right now. This is a boomerang monkey. If I use this, it attacks super fast. You can see, you kind of see it a bit really quickly. Yeah, see that? It attacked like super fast for a short amount of time. I'm gonna kinda, next round, I'll be able to show you the ability. Again, see these zebras? Again, they are immune to this, bombs and freezing. could see, if you could see that sometimes balloons instantly disappear if you pop, that's because it is affected by one of the eggs of the hero. Alright, my balloons are getting really through. I'm gonna pop an extra tower. This is the dartling gun. Basically, it's a very cool tower where I can really control the tower by moving my mouse, and the tower will aim at my cursor. So whenever I put my cursor, the tower will aim at my cursor. So it follows my cursor, okay? Okay, so there are more camo purples. I have to really be careful here. And I'm gonna upgrade this guy here. So this is one of the cool upgrades, one of the best upgrades in my opinion. Because this upgrade, although it's very expensive, it's 4,000 bucks, it turns your darts to mini rockets, explosive missiles that launch out from this gun here, and just deals a lot of splash damage to the balloons. Okay. So right now we are almost in round 50, which means that there are 10,000. No, not 10,000. I don't know why I said that, 10,000. But that means there are 10 rounds left of this game, okay? On medium difficulty, I have to play through 60 rounds. Okay. Okay, so we are now in round 50. This is the type of balloon I was talking about earlier. So these are blimps. They take so many hits, a lot of hits to pop, and the blue one that you just saw is one of many, one of a few, and that's only the weakest blimp in the game. Here's another one. Usually it has four children inside, which are the brown ceramic balloons. But in this case, it is affected by one of the acts that this hero does. Okay, this hero I'm talking about. I am starting to have a bit of trouble here. And because in this round they are camo ceramics, which means most of these towers can't see camo, but luckily this tower can see camo. Okay, so there are two blimps. Okay, I'm gonna show you that this one bursts into four children. Okay, so those two ones are affected by X. Okay, so I'm gonna show you in a moment. Okay, so this one is also affected by X. Okay. Alright, it seems that all of these blue blimps are hacked. So I can't really show you for the most part. Okay. Okay, so this one hopefully. Yeah, it pops and it contains like four of these ceramics. Alright. Is awesome, life is awesome too. Alright, another part of this game is it shows messages on after almost every single round. It shows tips on what's coming next round, like fun facts as well as some joke messages once in a while or something, but usually it explains next balloons that will come out. I am upgrading my farm, business to a point where I'm making $1,000 every round. Okay.
Slice and dice. Slice and dice.
Okay. We are almost into this game. We're almost over. We're almost done. I mean, we're almost done. Okay, yeah, I've shown you now. Bopping those blimps usually spawn for children. Okay.
Ready.
Here's another one. See? Yeah. Got that. Okay. There's more. There's another one. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you that almost every hero, like every hero, has some sort of abilities that can help you in the game. Okay. So there are two more rounds in this game. So we are now in round 59. They contain gamble lids. And if you regrow ceramics to follow up with that. Okay. We are in round 60, so round 60 is a special round because it introduces a new blimp. This blimp is a red one, and it's called a brittle floating behemoth, okay? So this guy is harder to take down than a blue blimp, which would be called a Moab. Or M-O-A-B. Okay, so we're damaging it. You can see that the balloon or blimp will show its wear and tear as it becomes attacked, as it is being attacked, okay? And we are almost getting through it. And inside it are four blimps for MOABs, okay. So it's gonna pop in second, any second is bops, okay. So you see four Moabs inside, which contain ceramics.
Slice and dice.
Yeah, there it is. Okay. We are getting through this game, and now we have officially finished this game mode. On this track on medium difficulty, and I will take home the victory for this game. So this game wasn't very difficult. It was still easy because I can farm, and I consider this to be easy, but fortunately, this is definitely not the hardest game mode. There are more way harder game modes that I can play on, and also way harder maps that are way harder than this one. And there are also game modes where I cannot even use farms to make money. I have to make towers, place towers on a specific budget. So that it can still beat the game without making extra money and relying on farms or extra money generation. And now, this is it. So this will conclude this video. I hope you enjoyed this Bloons Tower Defense 6, or BTD6 in short. I hope you got your ASMR tingles. It's been a while since I made a ASMR video on balloons or gameplay ASMR in general. So I've been recently making videos on dreams, which some of you might find it very interesting. So yeah, so this will be it for this video. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you next time.